Okay, so today I want to talk about mobile games, but with a specific focus on advertising. It's no secret I've had my gripes with some of the cinematic trailers that we see coming out of E3 and various other conventions recently. Things like Anthem have been a main talking point for me in a lot of different comparisons because it was a dishonest promotion that truly preyed on buyer excitement. But I can't sit here and criticize Anthem, or other major AAA titles for that matter, and ignore the much more egregious and also oftentimes hilarious promotion that takes place in the mobile market. Mobile gaming is a parasitic life form. While the general games industry attempts to emulate mobile game revenue and monetization, the mobile market itself is in a constantly degrading spiral of plagiarism, inadequacy, and false advertising. One of the major reasons why I decided to really dig into this topic is this ad right here for Dragon Awaken, which played relentlessly on my Facebook page. I'll admit that when I first saw it, I thought, wow, what is Dragon Awaken? Is it an upcoming PC game? It seems a bit like Dark Souls, action combat, great graphics, it might be worth checking out. Well, I was wrong. After one simple search, I found out that Dragon Awaken is just a shitty browser game. It is turn-based, and literally nothing about the trailer is even true. I got annoyed, did a couple of edits, and put a little comparison on Twitter, and a lot of people seemed to emulate my frustration. So much so, in fact, I decided to investigate the topic further and do an actual video on the state of mobile game advertising. Dragon Awaken is in fact a title available on Steam, but as a true browser-based game, I have also seen it advertised specifically under the mobile game tag and framework, so that is why I'm using it as the first example. One thing I was not aware of when I first saw the Dragon Awaken ad, if you can even call it an ad, is that the footage is actually ripped directly from a game called Project Awaken, which is being developed by Cygames. I don't know a whole lot about Project Awaken or Cygames, but it seems to be a legitimate title and was not actually developed by or even for Dragon Awaken. It is also not the first time that the game has even done this. Dragon Awaken appears to be developed by Game Hollywood, a Hong Kong-based company, and published by Proficient City, another Chinese-based corporate body. A couple of years ago, Dragon Awaken launched a couple of promotional CGI trailers, but those trailers were just low-res rip-off segments from Monster Hunter World. Played side by side, it's pretty clearly obvious what is going on. This is also not a rare occurrence. This is completely normal for the mobile market. As an identical example, let's take a look at Mobile Royale, right next to the official For Honor Marching Fire trailer. As you can see, it is literally almost the exact same thing, with very minor stylistic tweaks. There are also many more of these examples, mobile games that simply rip a trailer right off of a major video game and make small edits, if that, oftentimes they don't even make any edits at all, and slap it on a sponsored post or flat out release it as their own material. Now let's make a small pivot here. Obviously, ripping off entire video segments that have nothing to do with your game is problematic, but even when they don't appear to have plagiarized the content, it hardly ever even comes close to being an accurate representation of the game. Here is Mobile Strike as advertised by the game's official Twitter. Seems cool, right? First person, action-packed, verticality, base combat, a whole bunch of different things. It seems like it's worth clicking on. Well, here is the actual game. It is literally nothing like the trailer, not even close. Another thing to consider is that these games often pour huge budgets into their advertising campaigns. They work with celebrities, YouTubers, and streamers to promote their shitty products. Here is a Mobile Strike promotion with Arnold Schwarzenegger from the Terminator series. Yet again, the gameplay is not even close to a representation of the final product, and this promotion itself may very well have been more expensive than their entire piece of shit game. Here's the problem. Even when mobile games advertise real gameplay, real-ish anyways, it's still disingenuous. Lords Mobile is one of the larger advertisers right now when it comes to YouTube promotion. It's a popular game with plenty of money to pour back into marketing, so how do they spend that money?
He's trying to attack us. Let's just send in the cavalry. You think I might win this one?
Judging from what I'm seeing right now, he has way less troops than you.
Oh, he's shooting arrows. Wait, soldiers are going down. Why did they all die?
You see how they're changing the formation? Maybe if we go to inverse arrow formation, you might have a chance against the archers.
Okay. Let's see? Oh. Alright. You think they might win against the archers?
Yeah.
Alright. They're blocking with their shields.
Uh-huh.
Oh, they're going down. Wait, we're actually winning.
I told you.
Let's go.
Hey, they're swinging, running away. Let's go.
That was an example of paid promotional material commissioned by Lords Mobile. They were kinda cringe, sure, but the segment leads us to believe that they were really playing. They were actually playing the material. And it's a bit better than the fake CGI trailers, right? Maybe. But how about this one?
I just got ambushed by another player. They even have less soldiers than me, so I'm just sending in my cavalry in because I totally outnumber them. Oh, wait a second, I just died. Oh, I didn't pay attention to their formation. It's okay, I'll get into a scissor formation, surround them on both sides, and cut straight through them. Yeah. Easy win.
It's the exact same footage. They are clearly not playing the game, and even the keywords all match up, which paints a picture of a completely scripted sponsorship brief, which revolves around simply regurgitating the dumbass-sounding words of the Lord's mobile marketing team, who clearly have the combined creative brain power of a twice-fucked avocado. Here's something I am not supposed to show you. I'm going to block out the name of the game since this kind of thing is confidential and they don't want YouTubers to show it, talk about it, or reference it, but they never actually made me sign a non-disclosure agreement, and I'm also censoring the name, so if they want to make it a big deal, if they find out about it or whatever, I have no problem fighting them to the bitter end. Anyways, this is a mobile game sponsorship brief that I was sent. Let's read. Release dates, blank to blank. I can't actually say it because that would help people figure out which game it actually is, and it was fairly recent, so release dates are blank right now. Format. Estimated duration of the integration with the gameplay demonstration should be from 45 to 60 seconds, starting around 45 seconds after the beginning of the video, plus special download link on the top of the description box, and before any other text, plus pinned comment with links. Talking points, and here's where it gets really interesting. Please highlight the features listed below emotionally with your own opinion. Share your personal experience. You can say a few things in your own words, but try to be close to the text. It's also riddled with fucking typos and it's really annoying. The words that are in bolds should be used necessarily. Intro video. Please make a reaction scene, 5 seconds, using game intro video, which they supplied. 2. Forget everything you think you know about mobile games, because one of the most ambitious RPG projects of 2019 has just been released, and it's going to change everything. Introducing blank. Playing blank is the most immersive experience you'll find on a smartphone, and it can only really be compared with the biggest PC and console titles. The game is totally free. 3. It has all the features you'd expect from a brand new RPG title. Amazing storyline, awesome 3D graphics, giant boss fights, PvP battles, and hundreds of champions to collect and customize. Number 4. I never expected to get this level of performance out of a mobile game. Look how crazy the level of detail is on these champions. Please make sure to show 3 to 7 of the coolest champions in the champion index, panning and zooming to show the armor from various 3D angles. Blank is getting big real fast, so get in early. Starting now will give you a huge head start. There's also an upcoming special launch tournament with crazy prizes. Please don't forget to join my clan that just search for clan name and hit me up. So go to the description of this video now and download Blank. Only through my link to get 50,000 silver immediately and a free epic champion. Part of the new player program, courtesy of the dev team. Make sure you show this info as a text on the screen. Technical requirements. We strongly recommend that you, the influencer, will appear on camera, in frame, for some of the talking points. Be enthusiastic and emotional during the game to motivate the audience to play the game. Show the game on your mobile device. Show how you play the game yourself. Best to show the 5 champions in the index. Use the video original sound and music. Video asserts should be used in the main part of the promo. So there it is. That right there is also one of the more lenient briefs that I have read. Some of them will give you specific keywords and tell you exactly how many times to say them, like the word free or fun, and you have to say it 5 times within 45 seconds. It's really absurd. Even worse, sometimes they will give you phrases, which this one did as well, sort of, but they will go even further in different ones. For instance, I can't wait to purchase some of those complex armor skins, or I don't know, something stupid like that. Or don't miss out, buy the epic crystal bundle to get an edge today. It's disgusting. And they spend ludicrous amounts of money on these types of promotions because they work. People end up playing the games and buying the items because they were told to do so by a talking head that just regurgitated the words of a shitty marketing department. You can have a structured sponsorship, that's normal, requesting that a YouTuber highlight your core features of the product, like the game is about medieval knights, if it's about medieval knights or whatever, that's normal. But the mobile market in particular takes it like 15 steps further and constructs a rigid framework that removes all individuality, all honesty, and right alongside this, many mobile games are plagiarizing video assets and outright lying to their audience. How about League of Angels? Here's another example. They blatantly use screenshots of League of Legends, or just throw up artwork from Dead or Alive 5 with a link to their own download portal. All across the mobile industry, there are examples of this type of behavior. Our legal system can't keep up with the rapidly evolving pace of technology. The mobile game space is a cesspool of false advertising, but thanks to vague legal definitions and slow reaction times, before any meaningful action could be taken, it's usually too late and the trashy mobile game responsible has retreated into the shadows or simply phased out the ad, which makes retroactively punishing them a gauntlet of tedium as it becomes necessary to calculate damages, prove that the ads were detrimental to their established brand, and jump through a myriad of other legal hoops. The examples are spread far and wide. I could do a 30-minute back-to-back collage of crappy promotions and plagiarized content. Some mobile ads emphasize sex while zooming in on chest assets and showing nothing that indicates how the game actually plays. That's basically the tactic that Sword of Chaos went for. Other games are at least funny, like Mafia, which gave us an endless supply of "that's how Mafia works" memes to laugh at, but whether they are funny, sexual, or poorly scripted, mobile ads seem to typically have one thing in common. They are usually complete bullshit. The mobile games market is a cesspool, an enormous and rapidly growing cesspool, but it's still a cesspool. Now, none of this would even matter if the legitimate games market were not attempting to emulate the mobile market with increasing similarity. The true games industry is hypnotized by the low-cost, high-yield products and tactics that the mobile market employs, but those margins are boosted by disgustingly predatory decisions like just ripping a trailer off of another game and then throwing it on Facebook as an advertisement. I criticize the games industry pretty often. I talk about deceptive advertising, subpar release quality, and predatory monetization. But when it comes to advertising specifically, all of that criticism is echoed tenfold by the mobile market. If you see an advertisement for a mobile game, it might be sort of true, maybe, but as a general rule of thumb, just laugh at it, report it for misleading content, if that's possible to do in whatever platform you are on, and go about your day because mobile games have descended to a median level of quality that is absolutely disgusting at this point. That's about it, though. Since the law is incomprehensibly incompetent when it comes to the prosecution of false advertising, at least in the United States it is, it's up to gamers themselves to call it out when it happens and penalize companies that decide to perpetuate it. But yeah, that's it. If you want to support, check out the links down below. There's merch, subscriptions, stuff like that, typical YouTuber things, but enough rambling, I'll cut it there. As always, thank you all for watching, and have a nice night.